Right click damage is amazing to do to deal with.
No,
then the hook stomp. Oh, first blood on top.
Yeah,
looks like we have an early first blood that need to come in and just take care if someone want to someone want to cut the creep wave on top, then it's Gabby.
Oh, Gabby just playing it so aggressive there, moving towards the enemy tree line, but looks like we have a kill happening towards the bottom lane here.
Oh,
enemy lane.
It's very nice gank by Tim, so then yeah, and another fighter at a river. Maybe a frost bar here. Just stumped on the Enigma. And they strike back this time as Gabby brought his mortars now. And then this one, Jolly Phoenix, was brought down by three heroes.
Have a look at the puck, you can see, and it's off. He has 3 points.
He's really well streaked and just score straight away. Once he got his ultimate, dropping a dream point, and also illusory orb. Gonna be an easy solo kill. However, the BLG support moved in with a fadeboard, almost killed that puck. Armel coming back once again just to save his support. Got down. What a great start by TNTNC. And still, the BLG Unity still cannot stop the dragging the creep wave away from the tier 2. This is gonna give a lot of experience to TNTNC. He's trying to crawl back to that. See him is to get near him. Then how are you gonna get near him if you cannot see him in the mid map?
Oh, you finish it? Okay, just hold it up for now. What's happening here? Cyclops
in the river, and here comes the Fade Gold, and Ninja Book is gonna be the one who falls down. Pretty nice drive back this one by Team the Beauty, and they might catch that Phantom Assassin too. Flaking is back, if you even lift. And here comes the Crippy Find along with the Life Drains. Get sucked.
Yeah, beautifully done there by WG Unity, as we mentioned.
Can Pro doing something? No, actually, he needs to run for his life. Turn on the Burling Axe, he's gonna strike that.
Not too sure what is this itemizing.
One thing about, oh no. Snowball, that he might get caught nearby the shrine of the Dire.
That
be an easy
well.
Kill by Armel. About Real. I think it might opt there. Hey. Coming in, turn on the Metal Crown, just gonna slash down that the Apaka. He needs to just back off a bit. Nobody
dagger, waiting Reef in with the call.
Right
as well.
From the sideways, in the boogie side of the crossbars on the very low mana target. A black hole. Still on a cooldown, so it's on the scoreboard.
So I have to wait a bit longer for that.
Yeah, but Hoofstorm sorry comes out. Spike still connected at the very edge, and he's just gonna get chopped today with the double edge.
Yeah, we have to have a look later on, but the Silver Edge should be a pretty good item this game as well. Works on the PA, works on the Centaur as well.
Another gang on the Centaur. So many times that they get to the Centaur, he still get away with the Stampede.
Oh,
and his teammate moving in very fast. And very nice Paparino on the Hoofstorm, and just use the Storm on the himself. And he himself was melted down by the so many spells from Team TNC. Illusive Orb is one of them.
Yep, I think it's time that you can actually
learn. I'll learn some.
Yep. So I'll you see a stun coming, do you just change
Stampede this time they use for offense. Very nice long range spike on two heroes. They just did not hit
them.
Oh, Black
Hole,
what is
Black
that?
No!
I don't get it as well. Now it's time for him to just get away. Oh, dropping also made a mistake.
At the last second as well.
Yeah. Maybe it's time to go in. Here comes the snowball and an uppercut that's killed that Tim Chin standing along with the tag team. What a strong spell we have. Pucknut was about to get chopped down to the central run. The damage is just making the kill.
Yep. And now we can see the PA will be going for the death soul into the BK.
They're moving up on top and then power each other. Here comes that off with the earth fire and also sticking dagger. And just strike on that Tim's.
Have the tag team up with the Troll Warlord, another more amplification damage for them.
Oh, Hoofstorm, very nice initiation from the TNC side. They're about to kill the Troll Warlord, he popped his back kick bar and he just gets all the HP back with an uppercut help from his teammate. He made the kill! How did he survive and even make a kill out of that?
Well, like for the Troll Warlord, you're unkillable for the next 6 seconds. So even though you have the retaliate, it doesn't matter. 6 seconds, more than enough to get the kill there. And do you see the Rubik managed to get the stun onto two as well?
Armel, however, still on his killing bro on the once the kill already for Armel get rid of the Haka. But I don't think they will be able to stop the beauty from here. Oh, snatch the Aegis! No! Armel got the Aegis! But that's not how it works.
Now Bell Fury on the way to, do you think next item gonna be a Desolator or Blasting Bomb?
He already has a Deso, so the BKB will be coming up next.
Oh. But did you know that? No coming! Here comes Stampede and here comes the Chain Cross. Miles 1, 2, 3. Which is not... Oh. Team at TNC is smoke up and trying to push in the middle lane. Here comes the Stampede, I'm not sure where they go. Oh, they're catching someone at the bottom. It's Tristan. Tristan gone. Gabby finish up. Mercury in the matter of like 2 seconds or something.
Yep, the one Storm coming out with a double edge and the instant Phantom
wow,
Strike by the
Waller PA. Spent like 20 minutes for farming, but he gone in 2 seconds in front of the Phantom Sustain. And that is an eye inside with the Hoop Storm. Right inside of the base. Here comes multiple target. Sibling dagger deals decent damage. From the Blacking Bar, he's doing a black hole. This might be the first time they take rid of that Riol. But he himself will truly go down too, because Gabby is ready for a sleeping dagger. And
oh, a beautiful steal there by the Rubik. Managed to get the kill onto the Lion.
Yeah,
but it's not going to be enough.
Jumping in once again for the Puck. Trying to get that not thing to say. It might have, oh, the Crepify and also the Nidal Blast almost there. Kill.
That one should still be on cooldown.
Yeah, TNC definitely knows about that. No yep. Black hole.
No black hole. That's time to
this
hit up
a good day.
Oh, Goten jumping in there. Double damage. Just one slash from the PA. 2.3k critical with the double damage. Jumps into the home storm. Turn on the Black King bar and he's gone. Whoever in front of the PA will be gone in just 1 or 2 seconds. Look at that. Another kill for the PA. Double kills already. He go in. Maybe a triple kill. Or maybe he just clean them all off. Turn on. Oh, let it go.
And it's a full 5-man team wipe as well. I'm liking what TNC actually is. Decided to do. The moment they heard the ultimate coming up from the troll, they just controlled him. Stifling dagger, hex coming out from him, the finger was instantly used as well. And WG Unity not being able to make